Hello, it's JD here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Technical Juned. In today's video I am going to show you how to install and dual boot Ubuntu 21.04 alongside Windows 10 without any data loss, so watch the complete video without skipping any steps to avoid data loss. So let's get started, but before starting, please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new on my channel. These things are required to dual boot Ubuntu 21.04 with Windows 10. Now our first step is, create an unallocated space for the Ubuntu installation. To create free space, simply right-click on Start menu. Then click on Disk Management. Now in Disk Management window will open like this. Now here, you'll have to find and select the partition, which has more free space available. So in my case, the F drive has more free space, so I select it by clicking on it. Now right-click on selected partition. Now click on Shrink Volume. Now a new window will open like this. Here we have to enter a desired size in MB format. So in my case, I am creating 30 GB unallocated space for the Ubuntu. So the size is 30720 MB, which is equals to 30 GB. After entering the desired size, simply click on Shrink. Now, as you can see here, the 30 GB unallocated space is created here. Now close the disk management window and follow the next steps. Now our next step is download the Rufus USB tool. To download it, simply open your web browser and search for the Rufus download in Google. Now, open the first link, which is rufus.ie. Now scroll down. Now click on Rufus 3.14 to download it. After downloading, follow the next steps. Now our next step is, download the Ubuntu 21 ISO file. To download it, simply open your web browser and search for the Ubuntu download in Google. Now, open the first link, which is ubuntu.com. Now scroll down. As you can see here, this is the Ubuntu Long-Term Support Edition. You can download it, or you can download the Ubuntu 21 from here. I am downloading Ubuntu 21, because I created the installation video of Ubuntu 20.04 also. You can watch it by clicking on the I button. To download any edition of Ubuntu, simply click on Download button. Once you click on download button, the download will start automatically in a while. As you can see here, the ISO file of Ubuntu 21 is around 2.6 GB in size, so it will take some time to be downloaded. After downloading, follow the next steps. Now our next step is, write the ISO file to USB drive. For easy purpose, I created this folder on the desktop and copied the files which we downloaded in earlier steps. Now open the Rufus by double clicking on it. Now, here you have to select the USB drive, which we are using for the Ubuntu installation, so select it carefully to avoid data loss, because if you selected the wrong drive, the data will be formatted, so first verify it then select it. To know the selected drive is correct or not, simply open Explorer. Now cross-check, the label of selected device and the drive label both are same, like this. Now in boot selection menu, select disk or ISO image. Now click on select and navigate to the location where you downloaded or copied the ISO file of Ubuntu. Now select the ISO file by clicking on it. Now click on open. Now here, select the partition scheme according to your system partition scheme. If you don't know how to check the partition scheme, simply watch the tutorial by clicking on the I button. So in my case, the system partition scheme is GPT, so I'm selecting GPT. After selecting the partition scheme, don't do any changes in any other settings, leave as it is, and click on Start. Now here select, write in ISO image mode recommended, and click on OK. Now a warning message has appeared, now click on OK. Now the image writing process has been started, so it will take some time, so please be patient. I am fast forwarding the video to save your precious time. Now the image is successfully copied to USB drive, now close the Rufus and follow the next steps. Now we have to configure the BIOS, for the Ubuntu installation, to configure it, restart your Windows system. Now that the system is restarting, press and hold Escape key when the system is rebooting. Now the system is booted in startup menu, now press F10 key to configure BIOS setup. Now navigate to the System Configuration tab. Now find and select boot options and press Enter key. Now find and select legacy support and press Enter key. Now select enabled and press Enter key. Now select yes and press Enter key. Now press F10 key to save changes. Now select yes and press Enter key. Now press and hold Escape key again when the system is rebooting. In some cases, to save changes, you have to press the combination keys, which are shown in the message. In my case, the keys are 5597 plus Enter key. In your case, the keys may be different. Once you enter the combination keys, the system will rebooting. Remember to press and hold Escape key. Now again the system is booted in startup menu, but at this time press F9 key to select boot device options. Now find the select the USB drive, which has uefi label. Otherwise, if you want to install in legacy BIOS, then select the USB drive, without uefi label. After selecting the USB drive, press Enter key. Now the Grub boot loader is appeared on the screen, here select the Ubuntu and press Enter key. Please wait for a while, the system is booting in Ubuntu bootable USB. Now the Ubuntu installer is opened, select your desired language for the installer, and click on Install Ubuntu. Here select your desired keyboard layout, and click on Continue. To avoid errors during installation, please make sure the system is connected to the internet. Once the system is connected to the internet, simply click on Continue. To understand an easy way, I am going to switch the video to screen recording mode. Here, we have to select the updates and software, select normal installation. Tick this options, if you want to download and install update during installation, this will save your time after installation, this is best choice, if you are installing on old system. Now click on continue. This is most important step, to avoid data loss, please don't skip this steps, if you are skip this step, then you are going to mess up with your system. So watch it carefully. Select something else, and click on continue. Please be patient, the partition table will take some time to be loaded. Now the partition table is loaded successfully, here find and select the free space which we created in previous steps. As you can see here, this is 30 GB free space, which we created in previous steps, now select it. After selecting free space, click on plus sign. And partition window is open like this, here enter a desired size in MB format. So first we are creating 1 GB boot partition, to create it, simple enter a size is 1024 MB, which is equals to 1 GB. Select ext4 journaling, as file system. Select, /boot as mount point. Now click on OK. Once you clicked on OK, the disk will start to scanning changes, so it will take some time, so please be patient. After creating boot partition, again find and select the remaining free space. We are going to create swap partition. This is our remaining free space, now select it, after selecting click on plus sign. In this step we are creating 4GB swap partition, so the partition size is 4096 MB, which is equals to 4GB. In uses section, select swap area. Now click on OK. The swap partition is created successfully. Again find and select the remaining free space, and click on plus sign. Now we are going to create root partition. We are using all the remaining free space, for the root partition, so don't do any changes in size, leave as it is. In uses section, select ext4 journaling, as file system. Select slash, as mount point. Now click on OK. As you can see here, the three new partitions are created here, which are, boot, swap, and root partition. Now click on Install Now. And confirmation window will open like this, which is asking to write changes to disk. Simply click on Continue. Here select your desired region, you can select it from the map, or you can enter it manually. After selecting region, simply click on Continue. In this step, set up the user account and password for the Ubuntu. After filling all the fields, simply click on Continue. Now the Ubuntu installation is started, it will take some time, so I am fast forwarding the video to save your precious time. As you can see here, the installation of Ubuntu is completed successfully. Now click on Restart Now. Please do not skip the next steps, because in this step I will show you how to boot into the Ubuntu, if your system is not booting in it, so watch the video. Now remove the installation media, and press Enter key. To boot into the Ubuntu or Windows 10, first configure the BIOS, to configure it, follow the steps. Press and hold Escape key when the system is rebooting. Press F10 key to configure BIOS. Find and select the System Configuration tab. Find and select the boot options, and press Enter key. Now find and select OS Boot Manager, under UEFI Boot Manager tab or Legacy Boot Manager tab. As you can see here, two boot entries available here. Now select the Ubuntu boot entry from the list and press F6 key. As you press F6 key, the Ubuntu is moved at the top of this list and press F10 key to save changes. Now select Yes and press Enter key. Please be patient, the system is rebooting. As you can see here, the Grub bootloader is opened. Now from here you are able to boot into Windows 10 or Ubuntu. To boot into any OS, simply select the desired OS and press Enter key.